Beach FM, locals talking to locals.
And my very great pleasure to welcome back to Beach FM the person who's back is the Kapiti representative on the Wellington Regional Council. A very good morning and welcome once again to Penny Gaylor. Congratulations, Penny.
Whoop, whoop.
Well, yes.
Thank you very much, John. It's sort of like, because I didn't really get to do that on election night because I didn't get my results till 9:45 on Sunday morning.
So. Really? Yes, I accosted the mayor of the Kapiti Coast District Council because their results, once again, were extraordinary. Late, it was 11:03. Regional Council, District Health Board, far too late.
Yeah.
It's a tough thing, that health board, isn't it?
Yeah, well, all my colleagues had Ba Porirua, so that 10 other colleagues had received their results around about 5 o'clock on Saturday.
Oh, that's not fair.
And I was like, oh, and of course, you know, because nobody's telling you what's going on or what's wrong or why or anything.
No progress results.
No.
No.
And so you're kind of going, oh, is it that close? Are they recounting? Is it that close? You know, you start to mess with your head in all sorts of ways. And oh my goodness, is some hijinks happened or whatever, because years ago I was the communications manager at Ministry of Justice in a dreaded election where actually everything that they never even dreamed of went wrong,
yes,
including a bag of votes going missing up on Horowhenua.
My gosh.
So, having been on the other side of it, I know how things can go a bit pear-shaped.
Absolutely.
And there's all kinds of reasons it can go pear-shaped, but it would have been really good to have just had a little word.
I absolutely sympathize. That is torture, isn't it? Did they ever find that bag of votes from the Horowhenua? Do you know?
No, they never did.
Gosh.
One day when somebody dies, then the family go in and empty out the loft or the basement. They'll go, oh, should we
indeed
put this in?
Might be a bit late. I think they may have declared the final result.
Oh. I suspect it probably was well burned at the time.
Indeed. Penny, you will be accorded kaumātua status when you reach the regional council, because there's a lot of experience that's left the council one way or another, isn't there?
Yes, so there's 13 councillors on regional council, and there are 6 newbies.
Mm.
Now, 4 of those spots we knew were going to be new people, and then 2 are people who have not retained their seats, and there are new people in their seats now. And of those 6, 2 have had some council experience, or 1, 2, yes. And so, you know, there's some real, real fresh people,
yes,
fresh right into local government.
Mm.
So while I've done 1 term on regional council, prior to that I did 2 terms on the Kapiti Coast District Council as a councillor. So,
yes.
I don't know. I don't think you get to kind of deem yourself anything like that, John, but experience is good to have around the table, and freshness is good to have around the table. So
sure.
I'm still feeling pretty fresh myself.
Yeah.
But we all met. We had a bit of a gather-up on Sunday afternoon, which was really great. All but one was able to be there, and that was really good just to meet one another.
Yeah, great.
I've met a couple of the 6, but never ever met the other 4. So, that was really cool. I think I've got a good feeling about the group of people. They all seem to be the types that are well-focused and there to do the bizzo and take themselves seriously and taking their role seriously. So that's what we want to see.
It certainly is.
And we want them to bring different views, and we want them to debate rigorously around the table. We talked all about that, saying, you know, that this is the culture. We all really put it out there for our communities. We are really very upfront about our opinions. But there's incredible respect of those opinions, and respect that actually you'll put it out there, you'll be listened to, we'll weigh up things, and then we'll look at how we can do some consensus building, which, you know, is altogether a better way to get to a kind of a more robust
position. Okay. I must ask, at that gathering on Sunday, was the question of a prospective chair discussed?
Yeah, all that starts getting talked about straight away. because unlike district councils, city councils, where you, the community, elect your mayor, at a regional council for all of them around the country, the various representatives get elected and then we decide based on numbers, numbers of support, who gets to be the chair and in all the various roles. And of course there's, you know, lots of really cracker roles to be hopeful of getting around that regional council table. So probably by another 10 days is when we have our very first council, our formal council meeting, where we all get sworn in, and then we vote and elect and vote our chair and our deputy chair at that meeting, and then it'll all be public really about who's going to be what.
One of the councillors who lost her seat was Councillor Donaldson, who was much personified with the public transport issue and what an issue it was. And towards the end, she wasn't even turning up to the public meeting. So there's a lot of repairing of relationships with the commuters of Wellington to go on, isn't there?
Yes. Yes, and that's why it is good that, you know, there is some freshness around a regional council for the sake of, you know, the community looking in and kind of going, oh, great, you know, the new people, but also, you know, those who have been through it. You know, I only got one term of being through it, and I got to be in amongst the real rough stuff as it was cutting up and that. Mm. But, you know, what the newbies will come to realise is that local government doesn't make a decision last month and then things happen this month and then they suddenly go wrong. You know, it's taken years of developing these things. Things changed and the organisation didn't adapt to that along the way. So that's something that has been a huge lesson within our organisation. And, you know, we are working very hard to kind of just, A, get things working, getting them working much, much better, getting them working in the way they were intended.
And the way they were, many commuters would say, because it was the pride of the region at one stage, public transport system.
But I have to say the actual, you know, commuters of our region are still doing it. You know, they're still catching the trains and catching the buses, and good on them. They are, you know, people who are committed to, you know, the need for public transport and the value of it and the use for them personally, as well as because of bigger public good. So, you know, what we've made some decisions at regional council just prior to the election around us moving forward and faster through to a carbon neutral target by 2030, and that's about a big bit of that will be about our public transport and how we have it rolling around the streets, and that the chunk of it, if not all of it, will be electric. So I see that the newbies who are around the table are the types that will in the most support that, but there is good to have other people bringing balance and wide perspective. So I think it's going to be a good term. We're going to have to make some courageous decisions across local government, across the whole country, because, well, you know, there's that sale at the public transport. Foremost and at the front of our mind every day in our roles is climate change now. And whether it's coastal erosions, it's our flooding, our flood protection for our communities of Waikanae and Ōtaki, that is stuff that we have to make sure we're getting right, and we have done a really good job. You know, they've been doing a good job for years. So, you know, going back to your comment about Barbara Donaldson, you know, Barbara had been there for 15 years up now.
Long time.
While there is, yes, at the end of her five terms, the hurt and the burn around the public transport outcome, you know, and as I've said to her, and my, like, you know, gutted to hear you're not coming back. But, you know, I said, I'm thinking about the gazillion things, Barbara, you did for the people and for the environment of the Wellington region. And that's so true of people who've put in that kind of service
right.
a really long time.
And we do have to thank her for that. It was just unfortunate the way it ended. And it seemed that she was fronting for what appeared to me to be a systemic problem. There was something the matter with the system. You've mentioned yourself, the reaction was slow. It was unsatisfactory. And calming words can only go so far, Penny. I think you'd agree with that. So something has to be done there. But you bring up the point about the environment, which, let's face it, is the major job of the regional council.
It's the main focus.
And locally, we've had the first example that I know of managed retreat, which is initiated by the regional council. How much do you think this is a sign to the future?
It's the sign of the future. And so what I always, you know, in jest say, but it is true, Mother Nature is doing managed retreat. She is managing our retreat. So where we have human-built infrastructure, whether it's public, which is the case with the stuff that we do at Regional Council, or whether it's private, you have to get real and start thinking about when and how and what. Or, you know, it's either going to happen to you, or you might want to, and that might be your call to say, yep, let that happen. And it is a long game for some areas, it's not so long in others. And, you know, that's why we've been proactive at the Queen Elizabeth Park, because we have had infrastructure taken away through a very violent storm. And what that actually showed me was that the importance of actually moving some things ahead of them being violently taken away by the storm, because actually the danger that has been created, because there was half a bridge taken and a very, the obvious bit that was left was very damaged, couldn't be repaired. You know, you've just got half a bridge, folks, and that half, guess what, will not be safe for people just to add on the other half. It's completely compromised. But then I also thought about that half that was taken out, and goodness knows where it was, in the sea or up the river or further down the coast, creating other kinds of hazards to an unseen hazard out there in our sea or wherever. So, you know, there's a lot to think about. We also done a really good process, and I think this is a big part of the value of us taking a lead in an area where it is public good, it's public land, public infrastructure. Obviously not as hard as the decisions you then have to make when there is private property involved. So we've actually, you know, created a way of doing the consultation with our community that went really, really well. So also that's given us, giving other councils, confidence to actually start to have those kind of conversations with communities, because we don't want to, like, launch into it and start off in a bad way. And you know, that's the KCD feel, you know, come a time they'll have to have that conversation too. And having been in there when we did and didn't, we were looking for regional council to kind of be alongside us at the time, because we're all in this. So that, I think, the value of improved relationships is that regional council is very much prepared to be alongside KCDC and other territorial authorities when we all start to have these kind of conversations.
It's a difficult conversation, isn't it? 2.5 years ago, the KCDC, as part of a submission, I asked about managed retreat that I hadn't heard them utter those two words for several years. And it was as if I had created a really, really bad situation. Embarrassed, people literally looking away and shuffling their feet, and figuratively heading for the hills, which of course is what we've got to do eventually anyway.
Yeah.
But it's a difficult thing for any council, any politician, to break bad news. And let's face it, managed retreat for many people here on the Kapiti coast, emphasising coast, is bad news.
And the funny thing is, it ought not to be news.
Precisely.
So, that is the thing. So, you know, organisations taking their time, you know, gosh, I know we hate being local government processes when they're too slow and too long. Maybe this is one that we go, first up, we're going to say this is going to be a long conversation and a slow conversation for communities, and that will be good. It'll be good for it to be, start it, but be front-footing and say, we are going to take a long time with this conversation and you know, give people comfort in that way.
Penny, thank you very much for joining us. No doubt we will resume the conversation at some time, because this really, this managed retreat, this is one of the most important conversations that we're going to have to get ahead around.
It is.
Thank you for joining us this morning here on Beach FM.
Lovely to be back on the show.
Thank you very much. We shall do it again. Penny Gaylor, Kapiti representative on the Greater Wellington Regional Council.
106.3 Beach FM.